Welcome back to Horrors Worldwide. Today I'm going to explain an American horror thriller film called Green Room, released in 2015. Spoilers ahead! Watch out and stay safe. Four friends, Pat, Sam, Reece, and Tiger, wake up completely hammered on the side of a country road in their van, seemingly having passed out while driving. They are all part of the punk rock band The Ain't Rights. By seeing them, it is clear that they are not very successful with their band. The group slept all night with the engine on that farm field. Pat and Sam ride a bike to a nearby parking lot and siphon some gas to get them back on the road. The band meets up with a guy named Tad, and he gives them the key to his apartment so that the group can get ready for the interview Tad planned for his radio. He asks the band what their desert island band would be. Reece, Sam, and Tiger think of theirs, but Pat can't. After the interview, the band plays a gig, but their pay is barely split between the four of them. Out of anger, Reece pushes Tad toward the wall, but his friends interrupt before he starts hitting Tad. Later, Tad tells the band he got them to do a gig in a spot where his cousin works, and that the pay is better. And he also warns them that people are not very friendly at the place they are going to perform, but the group doesn't take that very seriously, since they have a good experience playing in front of unfriendly people. The band arrives at the venue, which happens to be a skinhead bar. They meet Tad's cousin, Daniel, who behaves a little rude to Tiger when he asks Daniel about his girl. The manager, Gabe, comes out and welcomes them to their refreshment room. As they are getting inside the bar, the band notices the board misspelled the band's name as the Aren't Rights. They go up to play a cover of Nazi Punk's F*** Off, which doesn't go well with the crowd. They then play a different song, which doesn't get much better reception. After the show, the band gets their money and is about to head out. Sam forgot her phone in the green room, and Pat goes to get it. When he enters, he sees two people, Worm and Amber, standing over the body of Amber's friend Emily, dead with a knife in her head. Pat freaks out and runs out of the room while calling 911. The bouncer, Big Justin, and Gabe force Sam, Reece, and Tiger into the room. Their phones get taken away while Justin holds them all at gunpoint. However, the 911 call gets connected and the lady inquires about the problem, to which Gabe tells there was a stabbing in the bar and he called to report that. Gabe then arranges two young skinheads together to stab each other for $600 as an officer arrives. He also promises the boy that he will double the amount if they end up doing time. The club's owner, Darcy, arrives and he says the band has to be dealt with. Inside the green room, the band attacks Justin and takes his gun, with Reece pinning him down and threatening to break his arm. Darcy from the outside talks to them about handling the situation in peace and asks them to open the door, but Pat, who speaks for the band, demands the presence of police to open the door. Darcy agrees to that since he had no fake stories to tell them at that time. Outside, Darcy orders Gabe and Clark to kill the band members inside the room and after that, they will transfer the bodies to the place where they were setting up a trespassing drama. Reece lets Justin get up, holds the gun at him after taking it from Sam, who has no idea how to handle a gun. Then he tells Justin to sit on the couch and takes all his belongings, including a box cutter. The club experiences a power outage, inciting a brief panic among the group until Amber turns on her lighter and sparks up a cigarette, which she gives to Justin and tells the band to watch the cherry in case of anything suspicious. The lights then go back on. Darcy then goes to the stage and talks to the people in the bar that due to the electricity failure, the bar is going to close, and he asks them nicely to leave, because Darcy wants everyone out when they take care of the band members. Then Darcy comes to the door outside the green room with a story that the gun they are holding inside is not registered, and hence he wants it to be handed over to him before the cops come. The band members believe the story and agree to hand over the gun but keep the bullets. Pat remains suspicious as Darcy says the cops have come and gone. Pat gets ready to hand Darcy the gun outside the room as Darcy claims there is nobody else with him. This proves to be a lie when Amber sees another pair of feet through the vents. Before she can warn him, Reece tries to attack Darcy with a rod while Pat's arm gets slammed and cut up horribly. Reece pins Justin back down and snaps his arm, then places him in a chokehold until he passes out. Amber finishes him off by cutting him open with a box cutter. While Darcy and the skinheads plan to get rid of them, the group starts to break through the floorboards for a way out. This leads them to a bunker where the skinheads run a heroin operation. There is no exit down there, so the group returns to the room. Tiger helps wrap Pat's arm in duct tape. With no other options, the group plans to make a run for it while arming themselves with some kind of weapon. Tiger and Reece run out, but Tiger gets his throat ripped out by a pit bull, and Reece gets stabbed to death. Pat, Amber, and Sam have to stay in the room. Darcy now doesn't want to wait anymore, so he decides to send people inside to kill them all. Daniel, who was standing nearby, asks Darcy to let him go inside to finish the job, because he wants to take revenge for the killing of Emily. Daniel and one skinhead go to the room, where Amber tells Daniel that Worm killed Emily when Worm learned that Emily was going to run away with Daniel, and now Darcy is going to pin her murder on the band. Daniel tells the skinhead to go back and guides the remaining three downstairs to get some guns. but Daniel gets a buckshot to the face, courtesy of a skinhead. Pat kills the skinhead with a machete. The three run outside with a shotgun, facing the skinheads. Darcy tells them not to shoot at Amber. Sam gets shot in the leg and then is mauled by the pit bull. Pat and Amber go back to the room, now both frightened and tired. Pat tells an anecdote about a paintball tournament he participated in, which he compares to his current situation, as he was outnumbered in both scenarios. He and Amber then come up with a plan to survive. Darcy sends two skinheads again into the green room to kill Pat and Amber. They find Pat yelling nonsensically, now with his head shaved and his face with black paint on it. He hops into the bunker, and one skinhead follows. The other skinhead sits above keeping watch, unaware of Amber hiding in the couch. She crawls out and slits the skinhead's throat with the box cutter. The first skinhead looks for Pat with his shotgun. Amber distracts him by throwing the bodies of Emily, Justin, and the second skinhead down. Pat seizes the chance to grab the skinhead's gun, but they fight for it. Amber descends with the gun of the skinhead she killed and shoots the other one dead. Gabe goes to the room as Pat and Amber make their way up. Remorseful of what has happened, he says he wants to go to jail. Pat and Amber force him out of the room with their guns pointed at him. They leave the club as the morning comes. Gabe takes them to the place where Darcy and crew are setting up the death of other band members to convince the cops that it was trespassing. They leave Gabe to find a phone and tell him to call the cops, while Pat and Amber go into the woods. Pat and Amber come across Clark and a skinhead, Alan, who is working on the setup. With the guns Pat and Amber are holding, they make Clark and Alan walk away from the van towards Darcy. Seeing them, Darcy is shocked and scared. Clark tries to explain the situation but ends up shot by Amber in the chest and he dies. Darcy, realizing it is the end, attempts to walk away as he draws his gun, but he is shot dead as well. Pat and Amber sit down as they wait for the police to arrive. They spot the pit bull, who walks calmly and lies by his owner Clark. Pat then tells Amber he figured out his desert island band. Amber says to tell someone who gives a shit. Meanwhile, Gabe reaches a group of people and asks for help by calling the cops. After that, we see some shots of Worm intoxicated with the drugs Darcy gave him, and Tad cleaning his apartment, expecting Daniel and Emily. So what could the band members have done to save themselves from that horrible situation? Let us know in that comment section down below. For more horror film recaps, be sure to subscribe, watch our other videos, and click the bell icon to be notified of the next videos. See you in your nightmares.